how many people need God to show them the way? How many people thought they knew the way, but need God to show you the way? How many people thought that they had the right way, but still needed God to show them the way? Can I get a witness? We all know that God is in control. Too wise to make any mistakes. Thank God Almighty for this, our Lord and our Savior. I want to give honor to everybody that's in the building in their respective places. Every president, every first lady, every mother, every deaconess, every minister, every pastor, every deacon, and every brother and sister that's in Christ. The scripture is going to come from Philippians chapter 4, at verse starting at verse 9. And before I go into the scripture, I do want to give honor to God, the Creator, amen, to my Lord and my Savior, Jesus Christ, amen, and to the persons of the Holy Ghost, amen, our God. Honor to our pastor, Elder Smith, amen, the other ministers on the pulpit, Mother Deaconess Sheila Payne, my wife, I want to give honor to her, and everyone else in a respectful place, my daughter. Praise down to cameraman. I want to say thank you. Verse 9 reads, those things which you have learned, received and heard, and seen in me do, that the God of peace should be with you. But I rejoice in the Lord greatly, that now at last your care for me has flourished again. Wherefore also be careful, but like opportunity. Not that I speak in respect or want, but I have learned in whatsoever state I am, mm-hmm, therefore to be content. Uh-huh. I'm going to stay at verse number 11, and the title for this gathering tonight will be called To Be Content. Mm-hmm. I want everybody to just take a half a second and look at your neighbor and say, be content. This is Paul writing to a church that aided him when he was in need. Paul had a lot of churches that he represented, but few churches came to his rescue in a time of need. Something about when you're in a true time of need. Isn't it amazing how people will help you when you really don't need help, but when you really, really need some help, really in a time of need, it can't be found. To be content, Paul is a great example of a servant in the army of the Lord. You know, one thing that fascinated me about Paul, he was not one of those people that just talked a good game. Paul was one of those people that could say, I'm a witness. Yes. Right. Not only that, he could say, I'm a member of myself. Right. Somebody may think that Paul had it easy, but this is the same man that persecuted the church. Yes. This was the same man that despised this man we call Jesus. Yes. A matter of fact, when it came to persecuting the church, this same man volunteered to persecute the church. Yeah. Isn't it funny how you don't be bothering nobody and you got people volunteer to try to bring you down? Yeah. Volunteer to try to gossip about you? Yes. You know, people say stuff nobody ain't even asking because they want you to know something about them.
Yeah.
But Paul said that I learned to be content in every situation that I'm in. I don't know for real, but I just understand when you are a servant of God, not when just your name is on the roll, but when you are a real servant of God, I believe in my heart we must learn how to be content. Can I just be real for a minute?
Go ahead.
People that we minister to, we know that we don't always like them. Mm-hmm. Uh-huh. Can I be real again? Because I didn't get no amens.
Amen.
When we are in this ministry, whether it's a mother or a deaconess or a deacon, we have to minister to people sometimes that don't like us.
Yeah.
Amen.
We have to minister to people sometimes that they make decisions and they do things and we have no idea what's running through their mind.
Yeah.
Have you ever said good morning to somebody and they say, what's so good about it?
Yeah. Yeah.
And the person that said, what's so good about it, is the same person that say, I want to give honor to the Spirit of Christ that's first in my life.
Yeah.
But what happened is they got out of the spiritual mood and kicked into the flesh.
Yeah.
That's why it says that we must follow, crucify, edify the flesh daily.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
It amazed me how people come up with all of these different types of characters and attitudes, and people have all these different types of habits. But it seemed like when we come to church, we put on the church uniform and walk like church people walk, talk like church people talk, you know, like, good morning, how you doing? I'm doing good, I'm highly
favorable.
Yeah.
Come on, Doc. Work it.
But to be content.
Yes.
It's hard work to be content when somebody rub you the wrong way.
Yeah.
It's hard to be content when somebody say the wrong thing to you.
All right.
Especially black folks. Especially saved black folks. Because I hear people say, don't they know I'll lay my religion down, get with you, put you in check, and then pick it up again. Because you rub me, you don't know who you messing with, you better recognize. But to be content. To be content. Paul said, I learned to be abased in all things. Whether he was sick or whether he was well.
Yeah.
Whether he was financially fit or whether he was in poverty.
Yes, sir.
Whether he was in pain or if just the day was a good day.
Mm-hmm.
Whether he had a crowd of friends or just one friend.
Mm-hmm. All right.
But Paul learned to be content.
Yeah.
I'm no Paul and I'm no Jesus. But just in my little bit of time on earth, I learned how to be content in the situation for Elder Payne.
Yes,
and the reason I learned how to be content is that I'm learning every day that you can't make nobody happy.
Yeah.
That you can only be happy for yourself.
Yes. Right.
The word content means to be satisfied.
Yeah.
The word content means to be happy.
Yeah.
How can content mean to be happy and you in jail? How can content means to be happy when things are not going the right way?
All right.
Well, the reason why is because this joy that I have, the world did not give it to me. My debit card did not give it to me. My degree did not give it to me. My friends did not give it to me. But the Lord that sits up real high and looks down real low, he gave me some joy. Some of the saints say unspeakable joy.
Yeah.
You know, and the world can't take it away. That's just this is why Paul was content.
Yeah.
And you see, I'm learning too that when we're servants, God tests us.
Yeah, yes, sir.
When you say that you're in the army of the Lord,
yeah.
And you're gonna stay in the army of the Lord till the day I die.
Yeah.
And then they say, I want to treat everybody right.
Yeah.
You know, God hear you.
Yeah. Go ahead.
But then there's another being called Satan.
Yeah.
He say, yeah, surely you move your hands from around him or her, he would curse you to your face.
Yeah.
So what am I saying? I'm going to treat everybody right? Mm-hmm. Are y'all Satan listening to that too? He going to see.
Yeah.
I'm going to feed the hungry. I'm going to love my neighbor as myself.
Mm-hmm.
I'm talking about to be content.
Yes.
What really trips me out, I'm a salesperson for the HH Grade. And what I learned that, you know, God spoke to me, and he told me when I'm dealing with people that really don't want nothing. They want you to go in the warehouse, check what's in stock, find out what price it is, and how long it's going to be on sale. And that let me know right there they don't want it today. But yet and still, I'm a servant. Because that's my job, is to serve them. Whether they buy something or not. Whether I like them or not. Whether I'm happy or not. Whether I'm sick or not. Whether I'm in a good mood or not. When I accepted that job, I accepted that job to be what? A servant. And my brothers and sisters, I know that y'all understand, because I'm looking at a lot of servants in the building today. Does anybody know what I'm talking about? Now, I'm just a salesperson. But now, with the body of Christ, you know when somebody rubbing you the wrong way, but you still got to minister to them. When somebody don't like you, but you still got to love them. When somebody, you know, people attitude can make you sick. I mean, really make you sick. I mean, a Tylenol can't cure it. NyQuil can't cure it. Some people attitude just so bad it can just stress you out just looking at it. But thank God Almighty we servants. That we can look past their fault and see something that they need. How many people pray for people that they don't like? How many people love people that they don't like? How many people minister to people that they don't like? And if we do that, we know that we're servants. I know some people might have said, if it wasn't for Jesus, thank God Almighty, I know I've been changed. Because we're content in the Lord. And the reason that we're content, because we take this journey serious. The reason that we're content, because we take our position serious. The reason that we're content, because we take even salvation itself as being serious. Salvation is similar to being on a job. And you get paid hourly. But what's funny sometimes is when you at work but you ain't working. You clocked in but you on lunch. And you know what fascinates me? That would be the person that get bent out of shape the most. If you pay them for what they really worth. I mean, you on lunch 8 hours a day. When you only work 8 hours a day. And if you got paid what you really did, you wouldn't have much of a paycheck. Okay, but let's turn it over to our spiritual bookkeeper called Jesus. We in the body of Christ, and the Bible tells us that we must work while it is day. And I know that everybody in this building want to make it to heaven one day. They told us that the condos got streets that's paved with gold. Matter of fact, none of us will get sick anymore. We won't have gray hair anymore. We won't need glasses. I'm talking about payday is coming. But we have to be content. There are two things that I learned about life. Everybody that's born is going to die. But the good thing about dying is not goodbye forever. But dying is going to the promised land. A land that's filled with what they call spiritual milk and honey. A land where there'll be no more hunger no more. A land where there'll be no more sickness no more. I wish that I could get a sneak peek at what my new spiritual Holy Ghost filled godly body would look like when I make it to heaven. It won't be no flaws in it no more. It'll be like Genesis when his Bible said that everything God made was good. And in God, we know that there is no darkness. I'm talking about being content. How many people tonight are content in the Lord? And mean that they're content. I hear many people, and sometimes it's a good thing to talk about it. I hear many people scared about who's going to be the next president of the United States. There's a lot of bad things that are going on.
Yes.
There's a lot of bad people that may get in charge. But one thing that I learned, that God is too wise to make any mistakes. And you know, one of these old days, there's going to have another election. And in this election, the Bible says that the government will be on his shoulders. You see, Jesus is running for office. And I want to let you know all you got to do to vote for him is to be born again. I can't wait till Jesus take office. I like Barack Obama, but I love Jesus. You know, when Jesus take office, there'll be no more crime no more. And the Bible says we should study war no more. And I remember Lee Williams said, there'll never be no goodbye. And he said, howdy, 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 every day. How would you like to be, how would you like for it to be Sunday every day? How would you love to have fun every day? Not worried about no bills, not worried about no economy, not worried about any crime, but I'm talking about to be content. You see, when we're content, we got this attitude that Jesus gave us.
Yes.
So it does not matter what happens to me. It does not matter what trial or tribulation that I go through, because I'm crazy enough to believe that no weapon formed against shall prosper.
All right.
And there's two ways you could do sign language. If you put your hands on your hip, that means pride. If you do your hands like that, that means you're content. So sometimes I walk around in the backyard content, because the day that I die, I know I'm going up with my Savior. And nobody, and this is for all the servants in the building, nobody cannot touch you unless God lets you be touched. And I know they made an old gangster picture called the Untouchables, but if you're a child of God, you are untouchable. That nobody can't touch you unless God says so. So isn't that something to be content about? When all on the ground is sinking sand, when everybody else is one, you know, people, when they lose money in the stock market, they kill themselves. Because money is their God. But I thank God Almighty that our God sits up high on the throne. Our God, the money say in God, we trust. How many people really trust him? How many people really believe in God? How many people really love God? How many people have a good attitude towards God? How many people are confident in the Lord? You know, faith is a good thing. Because the Bible says, without faith, it's impossible to please God. The Bible says that faith moves mountains. Move this mountain out of your way and cast it into the sea. Faith is a beautiful thing. But when you have confidence in faith, that's another story. When you have confidence in faith, you'll be like the three Hebrew boys. We ain't going to bow down to
it.
Throw us in the fire if you make. But we only serve where God. I'm talking about confidence. When you have confidence in the Lord, the doctors say that you ain't going to make it. The doctors say that you may not be healed. But I heard a scripture that say, by his stripes, I am healed. And I'm confident in that. What I love about God is he don't have no fairy tales. Because the word is true. And in the word, there's no doubt. And the Bible say, in the beginning was the Word. And the Word was God. And the Word was with God. Isn't that something? Sometimes we check our answer machines and get a bad report. But what I love about it, whatever the Word of God say, that's what we should expect. If he said he'll make you the head and not the tail, don't worry about it. Just have confidence in the Lord. Just be content in the Lord. You know one thing I try to do, but I'm not successful at it? I try to go through the day with no problems. Every time, you know, I ain't the only one. Every time we try to make it through this day, where there is no problems. We got the grass all cut. and there's a water leak in the bathroom. You fix the water leak in the bathroom, now you need air in the tire. But I'm trying to make this day perfect. I'm trying to treat everybody right. All you needed is one person to rub you the wrong way. But thank God Almighty, we're content. Because we know how to handle the people that rub us the wrong way. Another thing that I thank God for, and I haven't always been like that, or haven't always been like this, but we see everything that's going wrong with the world. This world is jacked up. There's a lot of bad things happening. And the Holy Spirit spoke to me. And he said, you know what God gonna do about it? And I know everybody in here has high expectations for God. But when God spoke to me and said, what am I gonna do about it? You know what the Lord said? Nothing. You wanna know why? Because he has you, and he has you, and he has you, and he has you, and he has all these content people that see what's going on in the world. Well, that's where you're supposed to be ministering. That's why we could tell our young boys and set examples to pull the pants up. That's why we could tell the young ladies at church how to dress. And see, this is the thing, we're getting on our young people all the time, but there's a word that the Lord shared with me that a lot of people are not paying attention to. It's called exposure.
Yes.
Y'all remember back in the day, we didn't always have Samsung Galaxy tablets that took good pictures? Amen. Some of us are from the Kodak days. Yeah. When you had some of them cameras, you had to wind up.
Yeah.
And then you had those big, gigantic cameras where you took a picture, and then you had to pull the film out of it. You like that? So it would dry. And if you messed it up, the picture did not come out good. And then, God forbid, if something happened to your camera or the film and it got exposed to the wrong thing, what happened to film when it get exposed to the wrong thing? It's no good. It won't take a good picture, just a black piece of paper. All right, we have a generation of people that are exposed to stuff that we were not exposed to. And we have people that pray for us. This is what I love about the old saints and the old mothers and the old deacons. There was things that they kept us away from and prayed for us, and they would tell us, don't do this and don't do that. I have to be honest with you. When I was a kid, I didn't even hear the worst sinner judge a kid. I ain't talking about saints. I didn't even hear the worst sinner judge a kid. I remember going and walking down the streets of Bemis, Georgia, where I was born at, seeing old men pushing baskets up to no good, but they would stop and say, son, don't do that.
Amen.
Because they was keeping us away from things that will expose us to corruption. So for the youth, my brothers and sisters, the only problem that they really have, they are exposed to more technology than we are. They're exposed to more people that can hurt them than we are. And therefore, we have to lead them and guide them the right. I'm talking about servants now. I'm talking about content servants. That we have to pray for people that don't know no better. We have to love people that don't know which way to go. We have to show people love that don't even know Jesus. And many of them are in our families. And this is what Jesus does. Do you remember when you got saved? Do you remember how you acted before you got saved? Some of us was a mess. Some of us was a hot mess. And we know what we did before we were saved. And we knew how we talked before we got saved. You know the difference between them and us? We had more respect, even though we was bad. That's the truth. You can't talk about Snoop Dogg and Dogg and you would look and listen to Al Green. They were saying the same thing in a different kind of way. Well, the difference between the youth and us is the youth just don't care. See, it ain't that they don't love you. It's that they in situations that they've been exposed to so much, the youth will be the first to tell you, it is what it is.
Yeah. Yeah.
There's certain things I see youth do. Man, I'd be in a casket if I did it in front of my mother and dad. I'm almost 50 years old. I didn't never say a curse word in front of my mom and dad.
All right.
I didn't never disrespect my mom and dad, whether they were saved or not saved. I never did. I always tried to be obedient.
Yes, sir.
Wasn't always successful, but I tried to be obedient.
Yeah.
And just because you're disobedient does not mean that you don't love your parents.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
Can I get a witness?
Yes.
Just because you were disobedient does not mean you don't love Jesus.
Yeah.
But thank God Almighty Jesus looked past all of our thoughts and saw something in each one of us that we need.
Amen.
And what God want to use this for in our clothes, this is a pep rally.
Yeah.
This is a pep rally for servants of the Lord.
Uh-huh.
For deaconesses that's been on the battlefield, some of them for a very, very long time.
Yeah.
You know, sometimes, and the Bible tells that in the New Testament, that the love of many shall wax cold.
Yeah.
Well, when you're always trying to do the right thing and always trying to love everybody and always trying to do what God wants you to do, that is hard work.
Yes,
especially when it seems like people don't care.
Amen.
It makes you hard sometimes. It makes you not want to be bothered sometimes. But thank God Almighty, we learn to be obeyed. We learn to be content.
Yes.
Let me hear everybody say, I'm content. And it's going to pay off. After what? To be content, what does it mean? It means no matter what happens to you, that you should still have a praise inside of you.
Yeah.
I heard that some writer say that he been discouraged.
Yeah.
I heard him say that he been broken.
Yeah.
But deep down in his spirit, he still had a praise.
Yeah.
And what I want to tell you, saints, no matter what you're going through, don't forget Jesus.
Yeah.
Don't forget why he have you on the battlefield.
Yeah.
Don't forget why we're here today.
Yeah.
Is to give God some praise.
Yeah.
Praise him when you can't pay the bills.
Yeah.
Praise him when you got overflow.
Yeah.
Praise him when you're sick.
Yeah.
And praise him when you well.
Yeah.
Praise him when you don't feel good.
Yeah.
But in everything, give God the praise. You know what's fascinating about that? For everybody that's sitting in the building, there's somebody that's your age that did not make it today.
Yeah.
And I thank God that he let me live to see another day.
Yeah.
And I'm going to say this, and I'm going to sit down and I see these basketball players. There's a basketball game somewhere in Tallahassee. And people practice. They get paid a lot of money to keep practicing too, but they practice. But the ones that are dedicated, that practice with all of their heart, those are ones that win the final.
Yes.
Well, I do my very best that I can. I ain't gonna say I love God with all of my heart, and even though you say it, you can't say it either, but what you can say is I love Jesus the best way I know how.
Yes.
Because when we love him with all of our heart, we won't do no wrong. When we love him with all of our heart, we treat everybody right. So Jesus, I love you the best way that I know how.
Yes.
But every time I mess up, Ella Smith, I get practice and more practice.
Yeah.
And Deacon Franklin, more practice.
Yes, sir.
And Mother Payne, more practice.
Yeah.
I never told nobody I was perfect.
Yeah.
But I did tell somebody I had Jesus.
Yeah.
And thank God Almighty that this Jesus let me practice and practice and practice